Hello everyone and welcome back to the Palace Zoo. It's a very special episode today. We have a real big modern building that's coming up this episode, and actually someone else designed it. Wow, well, yeah, Targ. Yes, I talked about him last episode too and earlier too, and he basically asked me, hey, Yoda, I really like your things, maybe we can do something together. But the problem is, he doesn't have the game, so... then he came with the idea of him designing something for in the Palace Zoo, and then I would build it with my own twist in some regards, and that's basically what this episode is. And also next episode, because it turned out to be a ton of work. So yeah, you can see me here building the main structure of the building. I had to look very close at his blueprints he sent me, and talking about his blueprints, let's have a little look at those now. So yeah, he sent me basically this master PDF file, and in this PDF file, every point of view is in there, every screenshot, every size of things, everything is in there, so it was like perfect for me to build with, and it's actually more challenging than I thought to build something like that, but anyway, let's just take a view. It's gonna be a Bengal tiger and an Indian elephant habitat, and on the left is gonna be the elephants, and on the right is gonna be the tigers. And the inside is very modern, and actually the animals can't see each other. Design it in such a way that they don't see each other, because well, otherwise the Bengal tigers would get hungry and the elephants would get scared. But the interesting thing about this building is that it's actually sunk below sea level, so it's 4 meters down from the normal height. This is the view from the right side, so here we can see the tiger habitat, and on both sides, so left and right here, and they actually have multiple levels to go on, so there is no crosswalk here, but I added that in this episode, so the elephants can go then from the left to the right of the habitat, and people can watch them climb over. And on the other side, on the left side of the building, is the Indian elephant habitat. And actually in real life, the males and the females are separated from each other. So that's also what I'm gonna do here. It's the same habitat, but I'm just gonna build a wall. And on the back, you can see here, this is basically the staff area, so only staff can get here. So here is the ground layout. You can see it's pretty complicated. On the left here is the Indian elephants are there. And there's a nice ditch with water for them to drink from. And actually you can see a separation wall in the center of the inside portion. And you can see these black boxes too. That's for scorpions, Indian scorpions. And on the other side, you can see the lower part of the tiger habitat. And then we have the first floor. We have a nice viewing area for the tigers inside. And also a corridor that leads to the outside section again. And it gives you a better view of the elephants. But anyways, let's get back to the build. So yeah, okay. Actually, for this episode, I slowed it down a bit from 12 times sped up to 10 times. Because well, I did like a poll on my community tab. And a third of people said, you had to slow down a bit. It's a bit too fast. So I did that. Hopefully it's better now. If it's still too fast for some people, I might either slow down a bit more to 8 times sped up, or just build a bit, then look at it in Tangent Cam, explain what I did, but I'm not sure if that will work. Yeah, if you have any like requests of that kind, let me know, then I can implement that a bit in my videos, because well, I try to improve my skills with editing and explaining it to people every episode. So yeah, I'm just doing my best. Okay, anyway, yes, building more of the main structure of this facility. It was quite hard, because normally I just do shove it out of my what's it called, my sweater, that's my sleeve. I yes, that's a saying here in the Netherlands. Okay, it doesn't matter. Anyway, there's not much to say. I just following the blueprint pretty much, and then I did some terrain painting here, filled in the little holes. Actually this took me 3 hours just to get the main structure done. And that really tells you how challenging this can be, because well, I didn't have like a Lego manual how to build every step, so I had to make the steps myself, and that was quite challenging. Also, you see me using concrete here, but I'm covering that up with either another texture, maybe plaster or something, or just soil, especially the roof. In this episode, I'm just covering it up with white stuff, but Targ intended it to have soil on top, or terrain, actually, like the normal terrain. But that's quite challenging, so I have to see what I can do with it in the next episode. I am raising the terrain a bit and making the barrier for the tigers. So the left area is here for the viewers, and then the right area is for the tigers. It's going to be tricky to get all the pathing done. Actually did some in this episode. Here's a dry ditch to separate the elephants from the people. Of course, there's going to be fencing and stuff. But it's also for next episode. Then I have these huge pillars to give it that modern vibe. I might change them later. Because, well, in the pictures he sent me, they were all black and very thin. But we are limited with the objects we can have in the game. And I can make them out of basic shapes. I just have to see what fits best with the overall look. Because I do want to have some theming in here. Of course, it's going to be modern, but there's going to be lots of educational stuff too. In very clever positions. And well, the palace so far has been very classical. Maybe except for the reptile house, but still, that's not as modern as this building. This is very modern. And that's what we tried with this design. Well, he did. I'm just building it here. I had to make some small little changes here and there because the game didn't like it or it was too hard to build. This is going to be a little pool here. But he designed it with these square edges, but apparently animals can't walk out of it again, so I had to change that a bit. I was having fun. I finally figured out how the habitat barrier thing works. So it doesn't matter what you build or how big the habitat is. It's just you can use any natural border and experiment with the transferable terrain, what's it called, where they can walk. You can really do some creative stuff with it, actually. So I'm happy that I finally learned about that now. Here's a little tunnel, which I'm gonna delete later because I thought, hey, why is there a tunnel here? Might as well just have the path in the open air. And here's all the back area stuff. So there's gonna be staff facilities in the in the lower part, and I'm gonna cover those up with soil on top so you don't really see it. Like a hobbit house, basically. And here's the skylight. I actually wanted it to be round in the first place, but then I basically realized that that's really hard to do in this game, round objects, and especially if it's not symmetrical, you have to like spend hours on that. And I didn't feel like doing that, but this looks fine. It also fits the very square edges of the rest of the building. Here I'm fixing the terrain around the habitat to, well, mainly for myself for now, to make it look like it's nearly done. It's not, by the way, not nearly, okay. So this is the tiger fencing, because, well, they are on this level here. And then they need to be 3 meters high, these fences, to not have them climb over, so a bit higher than that. Oh, I built a glass thing already. So you see that little bridge here, that's for the tigers, and people can see them walk through it from below. A little crosswalk. Thanks for John T for making that video, because now I understand how that works. And then they walk down here, down this little slope. And every tiger is happy then, I hope. I haven't actually tested if it works. But yeah, so for this sidewall, well, you've seen it in the blueprint picture, it's going to be... It's going to be all these little holes with the windows. I haven't put glass in it yet, but there will be glass. And then the big one, the square one you see here on the left, that's going to be for the tigers. And the little door here is going to be for the cleaner people, the caretakers. Yes. And the front is also going to be white, because I really like the contrast between black and white. Actually, it's mostly black in the pictures, but I changed a bit to white to have that contrast there. And at the end of the episode, it will look like a big black and white box, but it's going to be very green too. Especially when I've done all the soil on top or terrain. I haven't figured that out if I want to cover it in terrain or soil, because it's very difficult. So yeah, I had fun like covering it with the black. Well, this is plaster. Yeah, it's plaster pieces. See, I like the look of it now, but of course, it doesn't really blend in with everything around it. And that's not necessarily bad, but my OCD like tells me like it doesn't fit with the rest of the zoo. And that's why I'm gonna recover it in soil. And that's a very green thing to do. Maybe some solar panels, actually. Yeah, that could be cool. And not the in-game monster, because those need to be placed on terrain. And they are kind of big, so maybe some artificial ones. Yeah, I'll do that probably. Yeah, that's cool. That's for next episode, so. So that's a little preview. Okay, so also covering the entire backstage area. And then the next area, next episode's very detailed on making all the little facilities here and the props and the hay and all the things people need, the windows too, habitats themselves, foliage, yeah, pretty much all that stuff. So in the frontier, I tried to get a little bit more depth in the front facade, which I'm gonna cover with more foliage. You'll see that at the end. And here I, well, I had to make the stairs right, so that, first here though, is the slope for the backstage area. I'm gonna place a car down or a fan. Do we have fans in Zoo? I don't know. And then around the perimeter of the habitats, I did this border of the plaster to, well, from a distance, the terrain kind of glitches out. So I thought that was a nice solution. And then, of course, paths are gonna be there. People can walk there later, for the most part, and look down to the animals. That means they have their good view, because they are above them, and it's really well thought out of Tharg. Yeah. Going around here, it's not that complicated, really. Fixing some corners, and I thought it would be a nice solution here to have those weird terrain bits covered up with the walls here. So I did that. Here are the stairs, so people can walk down here and up, and also some a ramp for the people with a disability in a wheelchair. And I also deleted the tunnel here, so now you just go outside and you're on the grass, because there's gonna be soil. And this is the last thing I made for this episode. The basic shape of the front entrance area. So there's gonna be stairs down here, like tons of stairs and a ramp for, well, again, people in wheelchairs. I didn't build that here, but it's gonna be in this, well, hole. Very, very modern and really cool. I hope when it's finished, when it's all covered in grass, and it looks like one big modern hobbit house. Like, this is what hobbits would build if they would build their house now. So you can see me placing this soil. I really love that we have these pieces in the game, and makes it a lot easier to build stuff like this. Here I'm placing on the main roof, but I might change that to terrain later if that works. Also placed a lot of bamboo here, but then I realized that's really ugly, so I deleted that. I kept the apple bushes though. So I'm just experimenting a bit. Oh, yeah, a building was gone there for a split second. So I used these bamboo things, the Bengal bamboo, and they look a lot better. And then I basically chose a lot of different Asia, they can be found in Asia. I sorted on Asia, but Asian foliage and some things were on the wall, and I really started to like the look of this, some reeds. But that's it for today. So thanks for watching once again. I'll see you next time. Bye.